A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th March, on the front page you have very, very serious matters in CBI report on Sartha case. So the Supreme Court has now said that there are very serious matters which have come to light in the CBI report. So this is regarding the Sartha scam. So this was a chit fund scam, a multi-crore scam, a Ponzi scheme. Ponzi scheme means people are made to invest little amount like a chit fund, and then they would be given higher returns, but then actually the returns come from the funds which are coming from former former members of this fund. So it's actually not a scheme in which the money collected is invested in some constructive in some activity, in some investment, so that it gives returns and that returns are repaid, but rather they promise very high returns, like the amount you invest will be doubled, and they give those returns in a month, it will be doubled, and so people get attracted to it, they keep on investing, and when the amount becomes too high, it collapses. The owner of this scam actually runs away with the entire money. So that is a Ponzi scam. So this is, you can see, it involves 2,459.59 crores. So this is the Sartha Group's collection from 2008 to 2013. So it basically functioned in West Bengal, and many big names have been connected with it. So this is there. Then this is 70% of fleet will be airborne in a month, Jet assures government. So we have been seeing that Jet Airways is under a crisis. It has not been able to repay its loan. A bank-led restructuring plan was put forth. So the banks, which are lenders, they have become stakeholders here now, and they will be owning majority share, and they're looking for new investors. So that deal was finally completed, and the Goyals, the owners of Jet Airways, they stepped down. Their stake has been reduced, and now new investors will be brought in. So Jet has assured government now that 70% of fleet will be airborne in a month, because many of the aircrafts have been grounded, they're not flying. Then this is 6 choked to death after entering septic tank in Tamil Nadu. So this prominently comes in news quite often, and this is a huge disaster. So there are these septic tanks, because human waste, etc., they get collected in these septic tanks, which have to be cleaned. So this cleaning is done manually, that is called manual scavenging, without proper gears and equipments, which results in the poisonous gases there, resulting in deaths. The people choke to death in such cases. So you can see 3 of family are among those killed in tragedy here in Tamil Nadu. Then on page 5 you have, coming soon, a robot to clean septic tanks. So this is what a group of IIT Madras researchers are developing, a robot which can clean septic tanks. So mock trials have taken place. So this is very significant development, which is very essential, because many toilets are built in remote areas with narrow streets where the pumps cannot enter. So cleaning of septic tanks becomes an issue. And below you have, stubble burning menace emerges in Kuttanad in Kerala. So the practice, which is common in Punjab, Haryana, and is a major threat to environment, is being seen now in Kerala too. On page 7 you have, India's carbon dioxide emissions up 5%. So this is report by International Energy Agency, which shows that China, US and India together accounted for nearly 70% of the rise in energy demand. And below you have, China destroys maps showing wrong border. So China has destroyed over 30,000 world maps printed in the country for export for not mentioning Arunachal Pradesh and Taiwan as part of Chinese territory. So China claims Arunachal Pradesh to be part of its own territory, you should know that. And this is, government notifies new rules for drugs clinical trials. So these are new rules which have been notified. So this is aimed to promote clinical research in the country. So it would apply to all new drugs, investigational new drugs for human use, ethical trials, bioequivalent studies, ethics committees, etc. So here you can see what basically it does is that it reduces the time for approving application. So for clinical trials, so it has now been brought down to 30 days for drugs manufactured in India, 90 days for those developed outside the country. So this is again a question raised: is death due to mosquito bite insurable? So it said it can't be called death due to accident in malaria-prone Mozambique. So this is what the Supreme Court says on the matter. And there is sharp rise in H1N1 cases now. India has, cases have risen sharply by about 6,200. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Maximum Gambit. So this is regarding the Congress's minimum income pledge. It says this is high on ambition but low on detail. And this is barring arms. So it says in banning semi-automatic guns, New Zealand has set an example for other countries. So we know about that case too. The lead article, A Bridge to Nowhere. So this says that poor people are running from pillar to post as the Aadhaar payment bridge routinely obstructs their welfare benefits. This is a very important issue, that Aadhaar payment actually is obstructing welfare benefits. And this is an own goal for Britain. So this says that no one in parliament or in government is still clear on what Brexit means. So we are seeing the Brexit crisis developing. We have been discussing it in news quite often, which is in that context. On the op-ed page, then you have this interview with Congress MP Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath. So he says Congress has always been for cow protection and shelters. So he has been taking action against people involved in cow related cases. So they have been charged under National Security Act, which has been criticized by Congress leaders themselves. So he says that he is undoing saffronization of institutions and the loan waiver which he has announced in Madhya Pradesh. So he speaks on that. Then on international page you have MPs wrest control of Brexit process from government. So now indicative votes would be given by the members of parliament to chart alternative routes for UK's exit from European Union. So we have seen Theresa May, the British Prime Minister, has said that she will not go ahead with third vote on her deal with European Union. And then this is US upset as Russian planes land in Venezuela. So we have been seeing Venezuela in a crisis too. The opposition leader has been brought up as the leader supported by the Western powers. So US is now upset because Russia is supporting the government in power in Venezuela and the opposition is supported by, so now Russian planes landing here has upset USA because it will escalate the tensions here. So it says a reckless escalation of situation in South American nation is taking place. So that's what US Secretary of State says. Then on business page you have RBI receives aggressive bids, infuses 34,500 crore liquidity. So this is regarding the dollar rupee swap auction. So bids for swap auction are thrice as much as what was on offer. So aggressive bidding has taken place, which has helped RBI infuse 34,500 crore liquidity. And below you have, let Finance Commission function the way it does now. So no need to tamper with its structure is what former RBI chief says. The present RBI governor had said that a Finance Commission should be made a permanent body rather than being constituted every time for giving its report on 5 years. So this presently it says let the commission function as it does. Then on the last page here you have network of lakes found beneath Antarctica. So scientists have discovered a network of lakes beneath the largest glacier in East Antarctica. So this is critical in predicting how the melting polar ice will change the world's oceans in the future. And this is technoference is affecting sleep productivity. So this is a study which says that excessive use of mobile phones is making people lose sleep and become less productive. So this is a terminology which has been used, technoference. So these are the important news items. Thank you.